Hello everyone, this is Brajeshwar Singh and you're watching Immuno Live Top 20 News. Assam Chief Minister Himanta Biswa Sarma on Monday said the state will continue to be under Armed Forces Act 1958 and a decision on withdrawing it will be taken only if the present peace prevails for a longer term. He expressed apprehension that the militant groups might not reciprocate the same way if the AFSPA is withdrawn from Assam. The health department has noticed that some people have not yet taken the dose of COVID vaccine, even though their stipulated time to go for it is already over. Against this backdrop, the health department and the NHM Assam have started a mega COVID vaccination drive from today, especially to administer the second dose of vaccine. This drive, named as the Good Governance Week, will continue till December 24, 2021. Slamming the Trinamool Congress, Tripura Chief Minister Biplab Kumar Deb on Monday said the West Bengal government is being run by a company and not people. Deb also appealed to the media to showcase the situation prevailing in West Bengal and bring the statements of opposition party leaders in connection with the Kolkata municipal elections in front of the people of the country. 21-year-old Kawi Maningsiliu from Peren district is Miss Nagaland 2021. She was crowned with the coveted title during a glittering ceremony held at the Regional Center of Excellence for Music and Performing Arts on Monday night. Jemina Mautho, General Secretary of United Democratic Party, said the Congress in Meghalaya is now left to only a Khasi party. Speaking to the media, Mautho said, since most of the Congress members in the state had joined the All India Trinamool Congress, it is now just confined to the Khasi Hills. He added, the Congress is now starting to show its true colours. The ruling NDPP has welcomed the resolution of the Nagaland Assembly to demand the Centre for immediate repeal of the AFSPA. The NDPP welcome and support the resolutions unanimously passed by the 13th House of the Nagaland Legislative Assembly, so as to fulfill the clarion call of the people for justice and immediate repeal of the Armed Forces Special Powers Act, the NDPP said in a statement. Three people lost their lives while 35 were injured after a fire broke out in the premises of Indian Oil Corporation, Haldia. Efforts are on to douse the flames with the help of fire engines. Congress President Sonia Gandhi has appointed party MPs Santokh Singh Chaudhary, M.K. Raghavan and Ami Yajnik as secretaries of the Congress Parliamentary Party. Gandhi, who is also the chairperson of the Congress Parliamentary Party, has appointed D.K. Suresh as the treasurer. India has banned 20 YouTube channels and 2 websites for allegedly running anti-India propaganda from Pakistan, a report said. Among the channels banned, 15 are owned by the Naya Pakistan Group, while the others include The Naked Truth, 48 News and Junaid Halim Official. Union Cabinet Minister for Women and Child Development Smriti Irani on Tuesday introduced the Prohibition of Child Marriage Bill 2021 in Lok Sabha. The bill will increase the age of marriage for women from 18 years to 21 years. West Bengal Chief Minister and TMC Supremo Mamata Banerjee on Tuesday offered prayers at the Kamakhya Temple in Guwahati, Assam. Mamata Banerjee sought blessings from Goddess Kamakhya following TMC's emphatic win at the Kolkata Municipal Corporation elections. 7 months after its landslide victory in the West Bengal Assembly elections, Mamata Banerjee-led TMC on Tuesday again witnessed a thumping win as the party retained power in the Kolkata Municipal Corporation by winning 134 wards out of the 144 in the KMC polls. Addressing the media outside her Kalighat residence, West Bengal Chief Minister showed a victory sign and called it a national mandate. The US has designated Indian origin diplomat Azra Zaya as its special coordinator for Tibetan issues, and she has been tasked with promoting substantive dialogue between China and Dalai Lama or his representatives in support of a negotiated agreement on Tibet. Zaya, who was once posted in New Delhi during her diplomatic career, had quit the Foreign Service in 2018 in protest against the policies of then-President Donald Trump. Japan will allocate about $109 million from the country's supplementary budget to assist Afghanistan and its neighboring countries to address the humanitarian crisis in the region, the Japanese Foreign Ministry said on Tuesday. China on Tuesday opposed the establishment of the U.S. Special Coordinator for Tibetan Issues and refused to accept the new appointment made by the U.S. government. Xinjiang-related affairs are purely China's internal affairs, and China will never allow any external forces to interfere. The Chinese government consistently opposes the establishment of the so-called Special Coordinator for Tibetan Issues and will never accept it, Chinese Foreign Ministry spokesperson Zhao Lizan said. Singapore has reported 195 fresh COVID-19 cases, including 45 Omicron infections, while a cluster of the latest variant was detected at a gym studio in an upmarket shopping center, according to the local media reports. According to the latest infection statistics on the Ministry of Health's website, 42 Omicron cases arrived from abroad and 3 are local. Team Kang Lasha won 5 medals in National Muay Thai Championship held in Kuman Lumpak, Manipur from 16 to 19 December 2021. There were total numbers of 100 players. 7 fighters have participated in this event from the Kang Lasha Martial Arts Academy. And the COVID-19 update for yesterday, total cases 114, overall positivity percentage 0.37%, recovery rate 98.64%, and the dead case is 1. And that's the top 20 news for today. Thank you for watching Imoinu Live.